Jesus.
It's a little faster than the old one.
I like it!
Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Brad Wilmot. Oh 900 hours, Saturday, April 2nd, 2016. And Mr. Minkus has been here since when?
Well, after 7.
Livestream's been watching you for a while.
Now, that's done by hand about an hour.
Let's Jesus.
Done by hand in about 45 minutes.
Wow.
So that's the potential it has.
That's awesome. That would be absolutely rock starting over about it like that.
So,
the only thing I have to warn you about
is beware the seals.
Uh-huh.
Okay, or this one. You're fine here, but there's a rubber seal here. But
well, aside from that, here's my thought on that. You know, you got the seal there. We can leave these areas, this, and over to here, and then just do and whatnot, and just have it chrome and black. Because that's going to be a pain in the ass to get clean.
Okay.
I mean, acetone eats right through both layers of paint.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That's what I started over there with and took it off. It just turns it to gum and you scrape it right off.
Cool.
So if you wanted, you get a paint stripper, leave it on there, and strip it right off. However, going and doing it, and just I don't know how long it took him to do all this.
We did it it took a while. Like that's all day yesterday.
Oh.
With like 60 and 80 grit on a random orbital.
Yeah, stripping it would be a lot faster.
Go nuts. That one's gotta get stripped for paint. This one's going for polish. And this one's gotta get stripped for paint. So this is the one where it takes all the time, but the other two we just got to strip down to paint.
Yeah, you get paint stripper or a couple big jugs of acetone, some cheap towels from like Walmart or whatever.
Figure out what works best, and the thing of the day today will be getting the paint off of that and this. Because I got people coming out that are happy to help.
Well, like, let me check the lacquer thinner and see if that works with acetone as the smell.
See what works the best. My only concern with acetone is incredibly thick.
So, right.
But see what works the best. We'll do it in small areas and take our time.
Not a whole lot different from microthinner.
Yeah, there is that. Pretty much anything we do is going to be flammable as hell, but I think we can do it safely.
Probably. It's going to be expensive to get the gel-type paint stripper, though.
Okay.
But that stuff you just brush on, let it sit for 15 minutes or whatever, it starts bubbling up, you just scrape it right off.
See what works the best.
And you can reuse it like 3 or 4 times.
Okay. If we have to spend $50 to do this right, it's worth it.
Okay.
And I'd rather spend $50 and be able to strip the whole thing in a day than spend $50 on sanding this and have it take 2 weeks to do. So, yeah, go nuts.
But yeah, easy.
This is cool.
And
it's so much better.
But as you see, that's how I look at that.
You're starting with like a sand cast finish, and
hold
you're down. Just damn. All right. Wow, that's really impressive. Like what he started with. Like it's just a cast finish. It's really really rough. And that's totally smooth. So acetone isn't taking off the roughness of the casting. How are you getting that down?
Sanding.
Okay. How many grit is this sanded down to?
I went through and used I took it off this way. I mean, literally, you can just rub it off. But I did this and then started with 220, then did 320, and then 400.
Okay.
Then I did rubbing compound, and I found a piece of 1200 that I just quick used, but...
See, that worked, but I could have sanded that faster. That...
This stuff works okay, but, like I was saying, the acetone, I put it on there, and it literally just gummed right off.
Okay.
So...
You can do whatever technique you're most comfortable with, but I could have sanded that faster than that.
Well, then go get some, there's a big thing, I don't know where the sanders are, but the discs are right here.
Yeah, the sanders were, like, we used the hell out of them. Beck tidied and moved everything.
Yeah.
This is cool.
So if we actually got some 400 people in the watch vlog or in the live stream want to donate some 400 and 600 grit, I think they're 5.5-inch discs. They
oh hey, they're 5-inch discs.
5-inch discs.
5-inch discs and 8 holes. That's what we need.
That would make this so much faster once everything's stripped down to where I need to sand it and then polish it.
Okay.
Because that's what I did.
Watch out for this and these.
Well.
Plastic.
Yeah, well, these are going to be left black.
Oh, that one's plastic on here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. They're usually metal.
That one, see, if you do that, you leave that black, we get...
That's metal. That you can do.
Does this come off? It looks like it screws on there.
Everything comes off.
Yeah, well, because if we get that off, that can be cleaned and polished, leave the black ring in there, so repaint these, and have it...
If you're feeling terribly motivated, these actually can come out.
I know.
And you can clean under them, and we can clean the bolts or get replacement bolts, and they can go back in.
A lot of work just to make it look badass. And personally,
I have a feeling it's going to be a continuing work. Let's handle the 90% of it right away, and then we'll worry about the fussier bits. Up in here is going to be fun. That's going to be a whole thing.
That's what the drill and the attachment's for.
Okay, I believe in you. We got a 40-inch breaker bar on its way. A 40-inch 3/4 breaker bar. Yeah, I'm pretty happy about that.
Yeah, I would be too, and I am. It's coming to you.
And with that, swapping those bolts out, not a problem. Now we just got to get a big-ass set of drivers that fit metric Allens.
You don't have any?
No.
Oh, not 3/4.
And nothing 3/4.
So I've got ones at home that'll fit that, but they're not.
Yeah, we're gonna be getting all kinds of special size. Like, we need sockets that fit all that shit, and just all kinds of stuff. We're going to be developing robot tools. We're going to get a robot tool cart, just like we did for high voltage. We're going to have one for robotics. And it's a whole thing. So, all right, keep rocking out. This is cool.
See, the thing is, though, the thing that I'm thinking is, if we got a paint stripper, you could put it on here, let it sit for 15 or 20 minutes. Somebody could go work on something real quick, so you're not tying somebody up. You're not tying up a whole lot of man hours on it, or you could just kind of rotate people on it, too.
Well, we've got 3 robots to strip, so you can put the goop on, let it sit. Put the goop on, let it sit. Come back to this one, scrape it up, and you've got... Because I'm going to put 2 or 3 people on this today, and if we can just blast through and handle, like, 80% of the paint removal today, that would be awesome. Especially since some of the shit has to come off with a chisel.
Too bad we couldn't get a... media blaster and do it.
Oh yeah, I'd love to be like dry ice blasting this shit.
Or or soda blast or whatever.
Yeah, but dry ice blast, you don't have to clean up as much. It's not like we can take this thing and put it in the paint.
Right.
But, yeah, if we could dry ice blast it, that'd be the shit.
A little pricey, though.
Huh?
A little pricey.
Yeah. Well, a little bit for, yeah, just... You gotta have KUKA level budget to do that shit. But rock out.
We have KUKA donated level.
Yeah, we got that. And now we can get this out of here, which is cool because I want, what I want is this robot's gonna be NASA looking.
Okay.
So like white robot, and like we can color in here now whatever we want.
Right.
Which is cool. Because we'll paint that shit by hand. It's gonna be pretty. But yeah, the big thing that I would like to accomplish today is getting this clean and stripped as much as possible, especially the big gunginess of the base and whatnot. Because this could be a beautiful machine. It just needs love and time. And making machines really pretty, especially making metal really shiny, is kind of your superpower. So the whole world's been watching on the IRC this morning, and we've just been watching you rock out on the IRC. It's been awesome. So. Well, keep at it, sir.
Oh, I was gonna go do my cleaning. Yeah, I came in early because I wanted to take a crack at this and just see what potential is actually there. So now that it's 9:16, 9:18, I'm gonna go do my normal cleaning, get the building looking pretty for the tour.
Okay.
Then I was actually gonna start taking a crack at your boat too.
Oh, making that damn thing start?
Even though we're supposed to, when I was coming in, it was just starting, little flakes coming down in the air.
It's temporary.
It's Michigan.
Yeah.
Everything's temporary.
No, there is that. But you get that done, you can take the boat out, so, cool.
Well, first thing is first, I gotta get a spring for the return spring for the retainer kit for the Bendix.
Okay.
Because that one's shot.
Oh, it's great.
Like,
up. Okay. So, well, figure out what you want to do for these, because you can train, like, Katie will be here, Amy will be here, we'll have a few people on it. You can train a couple people on how to strip paint, and they can rock out on that while you're doing boat stuff, and then you can supervise this and make sure everything's safe.
Yeah, I think for the most part, right now, just doing the sanding, like you're saying, you know, it takes about the same amount of time, but without going out and spending some money on a jug of some of the stripper, and then
well, we've got a pack of 60 and 80, right. and
those will last a while.
They did this yesterday, and I did a lot of, on the other side of this ball, I did that, and this was Tyler, and this was Katie.
Okay.
So, and
just on it for hours. I'm going to lay the arm down, though, so we can reach it.
Here, hold that a second, I'll move the arm.
Now we can reach things
and sand. Yeah, if I can get this whole thing down to just ready to paint,
I want to have a nice, clean, pure white paint job on the whole thing.
Given that they took that and just rattle canned it, I mean, we can do better.
And you don't care about the slight imperfections on this one, so.
No, not so much. I want to, like, I'm not going to bondo it and stuff. Yeah. That one, it's a thing. But on this one, not so much.
We'll be back.
You require more man.
Hey, Casey. I can't need you.
Okay.
You can extend the short...
The robot's locked, right? The brakes are on.
Yeah.
Alright.
I can arrange for it to be more off.
Measure to the center of the motor from the ground, then tilt the arm down 90 degrees and measure from the motor to the end of the arm. Math, motherfucker.
Remove this robot, I kill you if I live.
I just turned all velocities down to zero, so it shouldn't be able to.
Beck, get on the bottom. What do you got?
12'1" plus tape measure width. So 12'1"
plus 3.5. 12'1" plus tape measure width. All right, what do you got there? That's a straight line.
There's
all the way
line.
To the ground. What do you got? All
right, that's 12' flat plus tape measure.
12' flat plus tape measure.
12'3".
Okay.
How long is that? 4 inches.
It's the same size as tape measure.
It's 3 inches.
Okay.
12'3".
Measure the tape measure with a tape measure.
No, the tape measure is 3 inches. It's a,
right.
On every tape measure you pick up, it'll have this, and it'll tell you.
Now you know.
12'3". 12'3". That's full robot.
Now we know.
So we went from 10'10.5" to 12'3". That's not bad. Your robot. Thank you. And that answers that question. You got with Dominic?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, cool.
Just over here singing the praises of the Ford.
Okay.
I've never had that before. I've always got them.
Right, and those are the ones that are always the easiest to get out.
What do you got going on?
Taking this apart. I gotta get the right size wrench to fit underneath so I can take it apart.
You gotta take starter out?
No.
That's the starter.
Yeah, I know that's the starter, but...
It's the starter. Figured that out all on my own. That whole thing there? That's the starter motor.
We definitely now need to get one of those floor Zamboni machines. Because I took an air hockey table leg to the face.
Why?
It's all his fault. No.
The air hockey table?
We were moving the air hockey table back, and this moose asked me to, and one of the legs, I guess, was being held by one screw, and boom. So we move it over. We're trying to get it back up and in there, and we moved the table, and the table was holding it, and the leg comes, and whap.
The leg fell over him in the face.
Why are you mean to Mr. Minkus?
It wasn't his fault. I was the dumbass to put my face underneath the table.
Okay.
Pretty good gash in your upper lip there.
Okay. Do you need a nap in a juice box? You can hook that up.
No.
Okay.
Juice gives me
Well,
gas.
You're the injury of the day. Do you need, like, a face shield? She's got a hard hat.
No. No.
We get you...
I need a
We're
bubble.
Gonna be in full hazmat suits by the time.
God.
It really seems that flat pack things, so it's up to what you're interested in doing. And then we have all kinds of auxiliary tools to go along with it, like grinders and bandsaws and drills and everything that you need to go along with that, and more workstations out here. So you can design things up front, or you can design things out here, or you can go back and forth between the two. Other things that we've got back here is we have a vehicle lift, so you can see somebody is using it right now, and it's a nice change of pace if you want to work on your car, say when it's snowing outside. And then, of course, the big thing that we've been talking about is the robotics area. So we can come over here and check out the robots.
Achtung, alles looking sepers.
Guten Tag, meine Damen und Herren. Das ist der Robot. And this is, we just got this thing like 5 minutes ago. This is the very first program that we've written for testing. It has not been tested yet. We were about to test it and noticed that the tour group walked in. We're like, oh, This is great. What could possibly go wrong? It'll be fine.
So, that's Justin. And this is the first major access test at full speed. We've run this program once now to test clearances. This is what it looks like at full speed. Sorry, cat. Never liked that cat anyway. Yeah. See, a cat knows the interlock's coming. Hey, cat!
There you go.
There we go. I'm armed. Everything's cool. Do I have to reset it? Yes. Give me a second. This is real science, man.
Jesus.
It's a little faster than the old one. We'll have Andrew working as well. This is Heather here, Andrew, and Justin.
Also down the side here, we have Larry, Curly, and Mo.
Are there any questions about the big robots? Cool. Here's the thing for you to remember. You now, at this moment in your life, have the ability to learn how to program a giant industrial robot arm. If you decide tomorrow that you want to teach this thing how to make pancakes, you can. What you do with it is entirely up to you. Our job is to make sure you don't break the very expensive robot and you don't kill yourself. The cat, totally cool. That's fine. Cats are cheap. But you can now learn how to program this stuff. And that's kind of a badass thing to be able to do. So, thank you. I will now hand you back to Moose.
So the program, where's Beck?
Beck.
Program needs to loop.
Mm-hmm.
Make the program
easy.
Loop.
That's easy. I mean, like, 5 seconds.
Okay. Robot works.
Oh,
I'm happy.
Do you know what a volt is? Like, the definition of volt? Electrical engineers? Cool. Anybody know what an amp is? Does anybody know what a watt is? Now, the cool thing is, these are words that actually mean things that are relevant to your life, and most people have no idea what they are. Just so that you two know, I'm about to make bright lights and loud noises. So for any full divers you're about to experience, perhaps down the back of your neck, I regret nothing. What we're going to do is show off three basic demos that we have in progress in here. This room is not, like, most of you when you tour places, anything close to this, you're in like a science museum or something like that, where everything's canned. And it always works the first time, and it never changes. If you go back a year later, it's the same stuff. No, this is actually a high voltage lab. The things in here are actually being built right now and tested, and sometimes it works, sometimes it don't. And that's just how science rolls. So, way more fun this one. So, what we're going to do right now is we're going to discharge a lot of volts in very small amps from there to there. This will be about 300,000 volts.
Perfect.
going to happen, okay? And if you, in about a minute and a half, you're going to hear this sound three times in a row. And then I'm going to touch you on the shoulder, and so that you know I'm talking to you. You don't want to have any ambiguity at this moment in your life. And I will say clear to fire.
Okay.
And I say, when I do this, I say clear to fire. You look out there, because that's where all the action happens.
Sure.
Your foot is going to look exactly the same after this. You don't have to foot. Everybody looks at their foot. Everyone's all there. So I'm going to touch you on the shoulder, say clear to fire. You step on the button, gently, lovingly, and hold it down until something happens.
Okay.
I promise you'll know when it happens.
Okay.
I always pick a girl to do this because boys, for reasons I don't understand, want to kill that thing. That's not my first button. They're about $80 a piece.
Oh.
Okay, so don't break my button.
Okay,
well, the girls, they come in, they just, and if you just tap it, it won't work. There's a safety interlock, so you have to hold it down until something happens. Okay.
Sound like a mask cast.
Yeah, it's kind of fun.
All right. Cool. Now, think of electricity like water in a pipe. Volts is how we measure the pressure of the water, the potential difference in the inside of the pipe and the outside pipe. That's volts. Amps is how big around your pipe is, okay? And volts times amps is watts. Watts is how fast we can blast you across the parking lot with a fire hose. That's the next half of this, it's fun. A AA battery has about 1.5 volts and about 1 amp. So you can get about 1.5 watts out of a AA battery. A car battery is 12 volts at a couple hundred amps. A regular wall socket in your house is 120 volts at 15 amps. That's about 1,800 watts. This is how you know the guy on Craigslist trying to sell you the 5,000 watt home theater amplifier is lying to you. There's only 1,800 watts in the wall. In a few moments, you will press that button and discharge 1,800 volts at 80,000 amps, which gives us 144 million watts of power. So for a very brief moment, about 3/1000ths of a second, you will discharge more energy through there than every building in the entire city of Grand Rapids is using at that moment combined. This will be loud as hell. Okay. If you do a really good job, you make a smoke ring. Now, you can plug your ears, but I have to hold the button, so I get these. You ready?
Yeah.
Occasionally we get some random science questions as well, that's kind of fun. And I have no notes, no possible way to prepare, and no net because I'm on live television. Because if I can teach you here to ask questions of people in authority and demand evidence, that's how we make the world a better place. And someday she's going to grow up and vote. And that matters a great deal to me. So, what do you want to know? You can ask anything you want. While you're thinking of stuff, in front of you are pens and paper and a report card for us for how good we did on the tour today and some basic info. Please take a minute and fill them out. And just raise a hand, I'll answer any question you have. I'm serious about this, you can ask anything you want. I've even gotten boxers and briefs, you can ask anything you want.
Where does one get a bunch of surplus United States Census papers?
Surplus what?
United States Census papers.
I have no idea where they came from. I've been trying to figure that one out for about 2 months now. We used to do this with really nice, expensive Office Max pens, and people kept stealing them, so we just used whatever the hell we scrapped. I know where they came from! We got a big donation from the state police. Either them, or we got the big donation from, it was the police one? Okay, yeah, it came from the police. We got a bunch of old state police office supplies, and this came in with them. How many of you know about Amazon's Smile? Okay, like three people. All right, I want to teach you guys something awesome. Amazon has a auxiliary website called smile.amazon.com. And I'll give you all this on a little slip here, one of these, in a minute. But if you shop on Amazon, if you simply go to smile.amazon.com, it's the exact same company, it's the exact same thing, everything's same. The prices are all the same, the same stuff. Anything you can buy in one, you can buy in the other. But the way Smile works is you pick a national nonprofit of your choosing. It could be the Red Cross or the March of Dimes or whatever. It could be us. And they donate 0.5% of whatever you spend to the charity of your choosing. They don't increase the prices at all. This is Amazon spending their money, not you spending yours. But for doing what you're doing anyway, you can support a local nonprofit, which is kind of cool. And this is the instructions on how to take 5 minutes out of your day to do that. It's easy, and it doesn't cost you anything, and you get to be doing the same thing you're doing now. But when you go and do your Christmas shopping, or if you take this to your boss, and they buy all the company's office supplies on Amazon, a lot of companies do buy a lot of stuff on Amazon. If you pick the Geek Group, we get a tiny fraction of a percent of that. If we do this with hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people over the course of a year, it actually adds up, and right now, we're making about $300 every 3 months. Which may not sound like a lot, but when you're a broke nonprofit, that adds up fast. So, anybody who shops on Amazon, I want to give you one of these. If you don't shop on Amazon, you don't want to. So, here. Who wants an Amazon Smile thing? Cool. Hand them out to anybody who wants one. It's stupid easy. It really takes like 5 minutes, and we put all the instructions on a card. Who else wants one? You don't get one. You're a robot weirdo. He's got the cool shirt. I'm judging you. Who else wants one? There, sorry. I don't mind running around. Anybody else have one? Cool. Thank you. If anybody else wants one, let me know and I'll hook you up. Alright, so give me a question. What do you want to know?
For 3D printing, what file format do you want?
STL files. And we can convert stuff into that if you have other things. We handle that one. Also, we have everything Autodesk ever made. And you can use it, and you can live on these computers for $20 a month. We have people that just hang out here all day generating, because that's 99% of the work is making the models. So you can do that here. Right now I'm working on one that's a robotic arm.
Like the, let's see, a couple of rocks, chess pieces, like how long would that take?
It depends on a million variables. Usually it's a couple hours. But it depends a lot on your fill density. For like a chess piece, you don't need really high resolution, and you certainly don't need much fill density. So those go really quick. If you're doing high precision stuff where you've got a really high resolution, or if it's got a whole lot of weight, so you need a high fill density, it takes longer. It all boils down to how much shmoo you have to goop out of the end of the nozzle. More shmoo, right? There's your technical system there. It's all about the shmoo. Next question.
What kind of shmoo do you use?
PLA and
ABS.
Yeah. And we've got everything from little basic toy 3D printers to the Stratasys over here.
We can do anything you want.
Next.
For the CNC machine, don't draw markers?
Yes.
That's the point.
And you can come here and make 5 of something or make 5 million of something. We have people that have come here and done production runs of things. Because it's fun to make a project. It's even more fun to make parts. It's really a lot of fun to make a company. And I like it when people come here and build companies. And it's happened many times. Next, go.
As far as getting trained and stuff, is there like, are there always people that
There's
are here?
There's always people to help you learn.
Okay, yeah. Right.
For any tool in the building, there's always people here to help you learn. That's what we're here for.
All right.
I'd like to say there are no stupid questions. Like when people ask me, how do I use this? I have had to take somebody by the hand and teach them how to use a screwdriver, and it took an hour and a half. That was painful. So, there are stupid questions, but we will get through them together. Next! It's snowing outside.
Yeah. What's your background?
I just want to cry a little bit.
Huh?
What's your... My background?
Yeah, what got you here?
I'm a nerd. No, when you say not here, understand, I've been doing this since 1994. this is my background. It was high school, then this, pretty much. I started this out of Grand Valley in 94. So this has been my entire background, pretty much. But my focus is audiovisual production, high voltage, aeronautics, those are my big three areas. I grew up in a machine shop. My dad had a machine shop, so I grew up sanding pilot chips. And I don't really do that much machining these days. I do a lot in high voltage, I do a lot in aeronautics. And today my focus is robotics. Because by the end of the day we'll have 2 working robots, which would be pretty good. Go.
Do you have any steel lathes or metal lathes?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
That big giant white thing in the CNC shop is a lathe.
Okay.
At the size of a minivan.
Alright.
And it's full CNC lathe with a Y-axis.
Okay.
So you can do milling on the lathe. All it's right. really cool.
Okay.
So, and we, the tools that we have always change. They always evolve. They're always getting better.
Alright.
But that's what we have today.
What about manual, like a manual metal lathe?
Go ahead.
I thought I'd seen one.
Not bad.
We just need 4 of them, 2 for each robot. I don't think we have a manual metal lathe in-house right now.
Okay. I think there is one down here.
Talk to me after the Q&A, give me a few minutes. The staff do not tune in anymore. I don't think we have
a
manual metal lathe. We may or may not right now, I'm not sure. I know we've got one out on loan. It's
right.
Way the hell more.
Okay.
But with the CNC lathe, you can operate it in fundamentally manual mode.
Okay.
Right. So, if we don't have a big manual lathe in stock, we will by the end of the summer.
Alright.
And that's the thing. If at this moment right now, there's more tools in this building for you to actively use than Home Depot has for sale. And if you walk in and say, I need this tool and you don't have it, we'll get it. That we acquire new tools all the time. I needed a big breaker bar yesterday. And I went to the IRC and they ordered a 40-inch breaker bar. So I'm gonna have to work to break something with that. Next.
I saw the CNC lathe, the other vertical CNC also.
Yeah, there's a CNC vertical mill that arrived yesterday. We're just getting it set up. If you want to help on that, grab a wire scrubby and get it clean and painted and work. You had one.
Yeah, are you doing research on smaller scale robots also, like Boston Dynamics?
Yes. Boston Dynamics makes some pretty big damn robots.
What's smaller than you got out there?
Yes, yes. Only the big robots go in the MDH. All the little robots go down in the robotics lab. And right now we're actively working on getting a pair of serial robots. They're just little 6-axis arms that would comfortably sit on top of this. Because I want stuff where I can take it to her school and she can get in robots. See, you hook them young, and then they're addicted. It's a good system. Someday she might grow up to be an engineer.
You guys also sponsor the first robotics?
No! No! And we won't.
Why Why?
Because first is a massive scam and I hate it. With a passion of a thousand suns. Yes, I'm saying that knowing you two are sitting in the room. Okay.
What do you guys?
I hate First Robotics. Passionately. Because of the way it's structured. Okay. Last year, up until New Year's, membership here was $40 a month. That made us pretty much the cheapest makerspace in America. Average makerspace costs anywhere from 80 to, in town, they got $500 a month for full membership, which is ridiculous. By the way, that's for an entire makerspace. It has about what we have in the front offices. I have a problem with that. Membership, as of New Year's here, changed to $20 a month. It's not about money, it's not about profit, it's about access. I want to help more people become smarter, because the world is full of stupid people, and this annoys me. It's why Trump is a frontrunner. I have a problem with that. First is a really great idea, and it started out a beautiful thing. And it certainly brought a lot of kids more into mechanical engineering and industrial engineering. For that, I think it's awesome. The problem is the way it's structured is terrible. You have to use exactly these things from exactly these manufacturers, and you have to pay a pile of money to get into it. There are huge barriers of access. Robotics is expensive as hell. No matter how you do it, robotics is expensive as hell. That's bad, because I want them to grow up and become mechanical, electrical, industrial, robotics engineers. When you go out into industry, when you have a job in the real world, they don't say, you can use only these parts from these manufacturers, make it do this. No, they say, well, that's what we got. Figure it out, make the damn thing work. The way we do robotics here is I have a giant room right over there. And they can walk in that room and build anything they want from any of the parts that are available. This is what you have, figure it out. If you don't have it here, there's a hardware store up the street, there's Industrial Surplus right there, and there's another place across town. You do it with, you figure it out. You actually solve the problem through nonlinear thinking. And if they come here and build a robot, it's $20 a month. If they use $50,000 worth of parts out of that room, it's $20 a month. If they want to take that robot home with them, which most people surprisingly don't, they want to build it, they want to tinker it, they want to race it around, we have to racetrack down there for robots. They want to race it, they want to battle, they want to break stuff. $20 a month. If they take it home with them, we go through the parts, and that Bimba air cylinder, which costs $200 to buy it, we don't sell it for $200, we sell it for $20, because we got it from the Industrial Surplus place, or it was donated by this guy. So we sell it for surplus prices. Because my job is not to make as much money out of them as I can because they're college kids and they're spending daddy's money and what do they care? My job is to get them access to be able to build whatever the hell they want as efficiently as humanly possible. Because that's what matters. I want them to be smarter. I don't care what they make. I don't care what it does. If they want to build a trebuchet that launches kittens out of the backyard, I don't care. I care that they're learning mechanical engineering. And my entire reason for being is to get them access to be able to do it. If they want to come here as a first team and build their first robot, totally cool with that. But I'm not going to sponsor their damn team. They're going to pay $20 a month like everybody else. Because it's fair. But everything you need to know about First Robotics, go to their own website. Go to the First Robotics webpage. Look up the pricing. Look what happens if you win. It's even more expensive. Ah! No, this isn't how you get kids into engineering. This is how you get really, really rich. I'd rather sleep better at night. So that's my angry answer for First
Robotics. I'll give you a short one.
Yeah. Next question.
Hey, what is the thing next year?
This? Oh, God, I just forgot. Does anybody have any idea?
A natural gas meter?
Yes, actually it is. It's a natural gas meter. This is a standard gas meter for residential use. You have one of these on the side of your house.
Are they the blinking ones?
Huh?
The electrical.
Oh, the smart meters?
Yeah.
Those things are awesome. They won't let me take one apart.
I think they charge more money now.
They're really expensive for the smart meters, yeah. They give you the meter for free.
Yeah.
The electricity pays for it. Don't worry. They'll get their money out of you. And if you think I hate First Robotics, that's my opinion on consumers' energy. Next question. How did you know it was a gas meter? You've seen this before? Yeah. It's like nobody's ever guessed it. You had a question?
Oh, I was going to ask the same thing.
Oh, it's a gas meter.
Okay.
Most people guess it's an iron lung, which I think is hilarious. Because, look, for a hamster? Any other questions? That it? Cool. Did all of you fill out your thing? All right. Anybody who's interested in becoming a member or hating on First Robotics,
walk up there and talk to the wonderful blonde woman who's happy to help you up. If you want to go home and think about it and mull it over and all that, I will give you one of these. Anybody who's really serious, there's membership handbooks up there, which is all the rules you need to know to be a member. I'll give you a hint, there's like 10 rules, that's it. It's really, really complicated stuff, like don't show up high. This has actually been a problem. If there's a rule in there, there's a story to go with it. Okay. Don't show up high. Clean up after yourself. Really archaic stuff. God, the snow's killing me. It's breaking my heart. I want to just fly airplanes today. It's just not happening. All right. Thank all of you for coming and having fun. And you, grow up and become an engineer. Hi. Be an engineer. Don't get a degree in anything that ends in studies. Just be an engineer. Thank you, everyone. You're welcome to hang out and wander around and annoy people. Please put all of your forms up on the desk there with Moose. Thank you. I'm going to go be yelled at by a robot.
I'm cool. Thank you. All right, we're starting 195. Keyboard plugged into this?
Where's that DT
at? Oh, we can't plug it in now. I'll have to do it on here. Was Andrew in the IRC?
I haven't been.
I don't think I've seen him this morning.
Can you hand that off to Casey a minute?
Casey!
Here,
can you blog a second? Okay, give it to Ed.
I was just going to get the keyboard.
Okay. The Windows Start menu from the keyboard.
I can figure it out. I don't think I've actually done it before.
I may need an external keyboard plugged in, we'll have to see. I'm just going to see if I can get it to move to start with.
I can't even see anything on the screen.
Don't. Galera will mess you up.
No, I mean me. Mm. I can't see anything. Oh, by the way, I ordered an AT to PS2 adapter.
Oh, cool.
So, it's on the
way. Now we just gotta get a PS2 to USB adapter, and then we're really cool.
Those we have.
I wonder if we can go from AT to USB.
I checked, I didn't see one.
PS2 is fine for here, because we got a ton of PS2 KVM cables. Alright! Registry. Power on, finished. Monitor, monitor, variable, single, got you, new value true, right? Oh, I just did all that.
Yep.
I did it from memory.
Yep.
Alright. Wants to be mastered.
Well,
everything there looks happy. She clicks.
not move. Hang on.
Where the lights down there?
Pretty red.
That is either the driver switch or the green button over here. Well, the one that was once green.
Secret button.
Was that one a button instead?
No, it's the thing, but give me your key.
See if that fits.
T2?
Yeah, let's try it. Just toggle back and forth real quick.
That's two.
Still off. Try toggling back.
T1?
Switch I find a little easier to use than the one left hand.
This is a dead man switch?
But it doesn't work if you're doing that.
Yeah, okay.
So,
alright.
It seems less sensitive to the squeeze.
I got green light! Moving axis 5.
I don't believe it.
Nope. It's not moving. I got green lights everywhere. Oh, wait. Hang on a minute.
The upper left is
standing.
Yay!
It's moving! First movement on Andrew.
It's about time.
He's gonna be like an old adult with his hands.
Damn it.
Oh wait, wrong Andrew.
Start calling names, not even. Five all the way up so I can see the whole thing.
That's why it was the first thing I was doing, is getting that so you can work on it. Here, give me a minute.
Okay, so unlike all of these...
This robot makes bad sounds.
There is no bolt on the end. I think this cover will probably have to pull. And there might be a bolt in it.
There's a manual for it somewhere.
A manual?
Alright, let's...
See, there I can get some vice grips and it'll be fine.
Ooh. Yeah, it's gunged up bad. We cannot move X to 6. Listen to 5. That's the software stuff.
Ooh, you can feel it vibrating your feet, actually.
Yeah.
It might be a little chooched.
No, it probably just hasn't moved in a long time, and we need to get lube moving around.
You know, Justin makes way less noise now than he did when he was delivering.
I say we can open up, see if there's any oil inside of his ports.
You mean like Jeff had?
Actually,
once we get to that point, we'll be doing a full fluid change on these.
As long as that main arm is back a bit.
Yeah, as long as
the one he just moved.
Yeah.
But it moves. We have two moving robots in a cage.
So now we can just transfer the umbilicals over to Heather and see if she'll move?
We'd have to load a different machine data, but in theory, yeah, we can do that.
What about Axis 1?
No, you don't want to move that.
We can move one.
Oh, one, yeah. You don't really want to move two a lot, but one.
Yeah, two and three is where it gets dangerous.
What is that?
That's one.
That sounds like something I'll go away with practice. Yeah.
Which ones are two and three?
Two and three.
Two.
They say right on it, you see A3.
Working robots.
Four.
Everyone gets better every day.
Four, five, six.
What's the difference between four and five?
So that's that sorted out.
Four is rotational, five is up and down, six is another rotational.
All right. We cannot move six on this until Casey fixes a plate, so that's a priority, because I moved that a little bit and I just watched the seal go.
No.
But we got to get this flat. It may be something where we just start knocking on it with a hammer to start.
Is this where the pin was supposed to go?
I'd like to take it off, but if I take it off, we'll be able to see what the gears look like.
They're chooched or not.
I mean, we have filled
without a manual for how to do that, I don't know. But for now, let's just try and bend it back with a hammer. Here, we're up against this. So let's see if we can get that hammered out flat. All
right, sanding team can go back to work.
Chris, can you rotate it the other direction?
I can't. It moves the thing.
No. I want this away from here.
Let me try.
Clear. Negative direction, I think.
Yeah, A6
negative.
Minus.
A6 negative?
Yeah.
That's what I tried. Watch over here.
Before you moved it positive.
That's as far as I can go without occluding this into here.
Okay.
But if you start smacking that, if you bend that flat, I'll turn it around and work it out.
Is that part, yeah.
Go at your tin knocking. I'll move that whenever you want.
Okay. That's not really tin knocking at this point.
Right, now get the display working. Now what about that monitor?
Yeah, I can get that going. But I gotta be able to get into, I need to be able to get to the Windows menu in here.
Look up Windows 95 shortcuts.
I may need to shut it down and get a keyboard working.
There might be a shortcut where it's just like alternate in the letter. In fact, I remember
there
may have been.
Escape, but there's no escape. Wait. No, that didn't work.
Look up start menu. Either start menu or a shortcut to open control panel.
Thank you.
big deal.
I'll buff that out. It'll be all right.
Yeah.
bending about there.
Right there. Okay.
Yep. You got about 7 inches, 8 inches of bend.
Picked it up with the forklift, they hit it. say six positives.
Six
about,
positives?
Yep.
About 20 degrees. All right.
But now nothing's rubbing.
So when?
About there. Right there. Yeah. Making more contact because when it was up here, yeah. Smashing it weird. Let's do a full rotation. Make sure it's not rubbing anywhere all right.
Would you? Would
you? Limit.
Oh. Well, you did like three rotations.
Yeah.
So. But he's got full clearance.
Yeah. What cabinet does he want, man?
Man, the amp cabinet. He wants to put the speakers in it.
You have to lift them up and over.
The door to
all right. Where can we put the speakers that isn't in the robot?
Was the only thing I could think of.
Right, but we would have to do obstacles that won't typically fit through the door.
Well, if we hit the door,
yeah.
How do we do up and over? Go in the seat, pull them up and out the basement, take them over here, and run them to the left. How do we do that?
You pull in some rope?
I don't have a better place to put it. And we've got that room set up as a theater. Like, we've got a good projector in there and stuff. And it's better than in here.
Right, we don't use them in here really.
Yeah, anyway. So let's Let's start with the little cabinets. That's easy, because those will probably fit through the door.
What, those?
Yeah.
No, they won't. No, the door's going strong.
Top cabinets?
The door is just not
measuring through them. Let's be sure. Let's at least get them through the door. That's step one, no matter what we do. not stock.
No, it's not. So unless they had it so it fit into it. I don't know. There you go.
Take one off the bottom too.
Yep.
In there. Cool. Do it on both of them.
What? Tell Spencer, look at this paper.
So actually.
Yay! All right.
Furniture dolly is excellent. So this is my thought.
Beaner, 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 beaner. Two shoulder length swings. Two a big slice and a big L slice.
Yeah, I know.
Bring it down on its front, and it should be fine. Don't bring it down on its back because you'll fucking attack it. Or it'll be just super fun.
You should definitely fight it.
Maybe you might just double it.
What about the sub?
Same way. The sub you bring down on its side. On this surface, it'll be cool.
Well, for all the speakers, the subs have this.
I know the top speakers do. I don't know if the subs do that.
These customers have this top and bottom.
Jerry's done with this thing.
gonna put this on a paladin, right?
Yeah, let's see if we can get the... I know how we get it up on the... I got the Johnson bars. I should pry it up enough to get like a 2x4 under.
Okay.
And I can pick it up with the forklift.
How are you gonna get it off for this on the paladin?
It'll slide pretty easy. What about those paladins?
We did. We got 2x6 under that.
Okay.
So you do the same thing like that.
Alternatively, you could
grab... If it wasn't so dirty, potentially, yeah. No, actually, no.
You could take two of those bolts.
That's what I was thinking. Put the bolts.
Put a sling across it and pick it up that way.
That's what I do.
Grab four of those bolts. 300-pound
weight limit.
Yeah.
This is what, 1,000?
Yeah, yeah, this is almost a... No, this is more than 1,000. The other one is 940 pounds.
All right, so it's like...
No, but probably about 1,100. Put four in, and it should be four.
Can you pull his car out, please? Pretty, pretty please.
There. Okay.
It's going to be really well balanced. I need another walk-up, please.
Oh, that's a nice shot of grass.
Thank you.
Sarcasm.
Crack pills, kids.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful.
That's good.
But the fire is so delightful.
Okay, now what?
Oh, and she moves out, we'll get the forklift.
Grab two of the short yellow slings.
They're on the forklift. Here, someone take this one.
I'll take it.
Good?
You're doing great. I'm impressed. Kid's got skills.
He didn't cover the microphone.
He's twitchy as fuck, but he'll be all right. Do you know how to use the voice-activated focusing system?
No.
Oh, okay. Fuck,
yeah.
There's a guy selling t-shirts that say, focus, you fuck.
You gonna send one in?
I want one bad.
Once that thing comes into the boat, we'll put that on there.
Okay, and then someone grab it.
It's ordered?
I set the envelope.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Chances are it'll be here soon.
It's professional.
That was actually cheaper than I thought.
Okay, bring your forks together.
This should be good there.
No, you're going to have to fork way more together because of how you're picking it up. Here. You got those flames, no need.
Take them off.
Okay. Here, take fingers off.
No, he just needs two of the straps. Oh, I know what you're going to do now. Got it.
You with me?
Yeah.
Lift up the washers.
Or it's not.
As long as it only gets it up. Okay, do the same thing there. Now, put a loop in it. There. Batman, come on in.
Looks like it.
Come on in. Come on up easy. I'll go back. You hang out of it. Now, pull this against that a little bit. All right, back up. Back. You got it.
More center.
Yeah. Lovely. Daddy.
Cool.
Stop. Hold on. Don't drag him on the screen.
Yeah, when I make the table, we'll just weld the legs right to the upright and then use those to tip it upright. Make it upside down.
Cool. That's that. Now we can step this out of the way and move speaker test.
Do the lunch first?
Yes.
Remember, it's a Saturday. Everyone has to leave at once.
At lunch?
I'm going to set this right in front of the house.
Put it back over the circle, put this car back in, and put it behind it.
Then steal the key from the forklift and hide the mallet. I've never done that before. I actually did do something like that. And you know what he did?
No.
He just drove, well, it was, I watched him from coming in, he just drove it straight.
To clean that out, it could be that easy.
Yep.
Because it's just to you, primarily right here. And if they want their own.
One from there, one from there. Two separate workstations.
And at least one, I want a real computer here. For, I want two people to be able to program. The kernel. And on that one, you need a, it's all going to be PS2. That computer has an AT keyboard. So I need an AT. Yeah, I need an AT to PS2.
Go make it happen.
Cool.
Cool. Which one?
At some point, chisel this out. Because there's still some heavy nasty.
Oh, right.
Do you hit it with a grinder or just...
Okay. I got the right
the
grinder?
Yeah, I had some under here.
What grinder?
That's
sander.
Sander.
Okay. Cool. Okay. If it works.
Ha! Ha! Hey! Yeah!
The slag.
Give me that!
The slag hammer.
Give me that!
Take A3 negative for me a bit. I need to go up and Bring A3 negative, bring A2 down.
Yes, they do.
Oh.
Especially when you hit the cord with the earphone.
Come on down, bring two down. That's lovely right there, thank you. Jesus. I need to switch places. I'm gonna have to go in there with a chisel. There's rocks coming off my robot! Yeah, this is too bendy for what we want. It's because of spring head. You can't aim it for precision use in there, but... Yeah, I need a chisel and a small ball peen. Can you grab me one? Oh, yeah. Here, I'll trade you. This is what I wanted. Follow them, that's going to be a circus. I'm chiseling shit off a robot.
Where are you guys going?
Studio A.
Where are you going up at?
We have to go
What room are you going up in?
Huh?
What room are you going up in?
One more time.
Where are you going up at?
Through there.
You gotta take him through the door, up the staircase.
Oh, okay.
Through the door, up the staircase, and throw it out the window. Let me
draw. Not studio?
Huh?
Not studio?
Studio way.
They're going.
We have to go up.
We're going up the stairs
and
then down
studio. We have to throw the ladder and all the speakers out the window.
I'm kind of confused, but you
open the door.
Open the door and go upstairs.
There's a window on the second floor
that
looks
on the
down on A.
We need the ladder too, yeah.
Yeah, I know, but I only have so many hands and holding the door and...
Understandable.
Ladder at the same time.
That looks like a freaking like, laser shot from like a blaster or something.
What?
I was looking at a little camera screen and because of that the white streak.
Yeah.
And all you could see was the shot in front of it.
Really?
Up a little more, Katie.
Yeah, there we go.
Got it? Tyler can catch.
No, we just slide it.
And now it just leans up against the wall.
All right, Tyler, lean it up against the wall. On the floor.
And then that is our platform for sliding the speakers down.
Do we need more angle than
that?
This is all we have for sliding the
angle. You could probably get more angle out of it. We'll have somebody down at the bottom footing the ladder, but knowing well enough to get the hell out of the way if we drop it.
Are we gonna take each speaker up one at a time and slide it down, or are we going to take all of them up?
It's up to you. Want to do it in stages?
Bring them all up.
Yeah. I
say all right, let's do it in stages first. Let's get the speakers up here.
Katie, let's move this stuff so that they can stack speakers up. Just push it up against the wall. It's fine.
Can do is turn the speaker around, lift down on his back, and then four people, one.
Got it. This is where it gets really tricky, just trying to slide the usual thing through the door.
Yeah.
But we're sliding.
No.
No,
you gotta carry it.
You have to lift this thing.
You can't put it sideways.
There's handles on each side.
Yeah.
There's four handles, two here and two
for
there. Well, there's also two.
Huh?
Beth will be happy. No, I think this is the second one. Mm-hmm. This one doesn't have the weird leg. The other one has like magnets.
Unless you are willing to replace the door.
Let's just push
with your own funds and own time and own energy.
Slide it through the door.
TJ, let Tyler in, he can lift.
Yeah.
Can you grab the handle, son?
There are handles on the side, Tyler.
Got it?
Yep. You guys are squishing Katie.
Katie, can you get on this side of the speaker?
Yeah. Let's hang out here.
Oh. This is a shitty, shitty thing.
It's okay, Steve.
Okay, I'm on the landing. Landing. These are the heavy ones. The subwoofer's oddly enough lighter. They're physically larger, but they're lighter because they're mostly air. Yeah, they're gonna be awkward as hell.
That's as far as that door will open. And you've got a big brick. Tyler, watch the brick in your knee.
Can we get it, bud? Can we set it up on the landing?
Are we on the landing?
Yes.
Yeah, totally.
We are.
No, we're not. Okay, now we are.
Now we are.
Okay. Our side handles.
Found it.
Let's just set it down flat. Okay.
That was fun.
Hey, Chris.
We can do it.
Yay, Steven's here to catch. Bellatini's down there now.
Huh?
Bellatini's down there now.
Where is the speaker going?
Down.
Yeah. That's gonna be a fun part.
That was the easy part.
I think they're gonna bring all the speakers up first and then we'll slide them down.
Okay.
Oh, I was just speculating about how we need to.
How we need to what? I'm all for this.
That's the end.
You okay, editor?
Yeah, just take a breath.
Okay.
Better have to come out of that room now. Not the old man.
No, he's open out in pieces.
Yeah.
Why are we putting him in there?
Captain.
Yeah, but why does he want them in there?
He doesn't want them in the robot cage.
So naturally, we put them in the room, we get it.
This is the movie.
There is no
naturally,
other interpretation.
Big speakers.
We put it in the room, we can't take it out of them again. Naturally.
They're not coming out ever again.
That means if Chris wants to move them again, he can't.
Well, that's
we
the
can
thing.
Tell
there
him
isn't
he
even a
can't.
Way to, there isn't even a way to go the door, make the door wider. There isn't.
We can't make the door.
No, I know.
Without
that's
breaking
insane.
A lot of things.
Well, we can't. There's somebody qualified to wind the door.
We couldn't do it safely or legally for that matter.
Does anybody know where Becky is?
Nope.
Becky?
Beck or Becky?
Did she make her way? Is the door down there open?
No, it is not.
Okay.
Nope.
She is not in the AV wing either.
So, are we ready for this?
Tyler
says we're not ready yet.
Oh. Here they come, editor.
There are people still.
This is awkward.
Yes, it is. This.
Squish
anybody.
Oh, tomorrow, then I'm gonna have to pee. Check me around so you don't squish.
Oh,
I can't.
Okay, let it
go.
Okay.
Am I blinking?
No. It was on.
Okay.
It was on. I turned it off.
Thank you.
No! Let's, we have to stand it up anyway. So let's stand it up. Can you watch your foot?
It doesn't matter, Ty, it's fine.
Okay.
It does not matter.
Just flip it. How's your name?
Okay. Now for the lighter, get more arc.
These are lighter, but they're heavier towards the front.
I found the front.
They don't feel lighter.
Lift it up and...
Oh, it's lighter. It's a lot lighter.
You got it, Tyler?
Yeah.
Door.
On the wall.
Frame.
And another... Handle.
A little bit later.
I feel like the handles are positioned better though.
This is more, it's like more of a flat ground.
It's like they knew it would be hard to move and they actually did small things to help.
Yeah, they didn't move for 20 years. Oh my god.
20 years? We don't have nothing for.
This came out of the planetarium.
Yeah. Like.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, you can slide it.
How do we get through the door?
Yeah, magic.
From the hole to the door.
Sorcery.
And the person slides.
I had a good read to it.
You hold the door in the corner.
Watch your feet.
One with the wall, you'll be fine.
Door frame.
Okay. One more to go, we'll get to the hard part.
Yeah. One more.
The harder. The sad thing is, the one component of this entire sound system that will actually fit through the door has to come up here anyway. It goes there. So all the wires into this room comes up here.
Okay.
I know. Okay. Yeah, that was an advantage. I just...
Merry Christmas. Have a...
No.
You okay?
What?
You okay?
I'm
okay?
Fine.
There's Maggie. She's awful. That's all she can help.
Hello, Maggie can lift this up by herself.
Just put it on her back. Put it on her back and then hold the treat up at the top of the stairs.
got it. TJ's doing this one.
Take a break, man.
No.
Okay, you got it.
Freaking girls. Lift shit.
Well, then why do we only have one person on the end? Get your feet out of there.
It's possible that it's less awkward to carry.
There's not, it's up there.
But it's heavier.
Oh. It's the awkward thing, really.
Oh, yeah, the steps are 5-4, 5-4.
And we have to figure out a safe way to do that because this one doesn't exactly have the nice little fun hooks that those do. So,
press the X.
Can I borrow a radio? Yeah, my radio's down in the hallway there. Go ahead, Beth.
I want like two people lifting up over,
okay,
while like everyone else is holding onto their legs. That's right. It's gonna suck for the first few feet until Casey and I can help relieve weight. Understood.
What?
All right, let's do this.
Two people. Up over the thing. Everyone else holds the crap for dear life. Focus on until they can start actually supporting it.
Of course, our hand is in the middle.
Everybody's honest.
No one's ready for this.
Okay, you ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Tilt it.
Just saw the light. Oh, my eyes. It's very boring. Alright, now you're on the ladder. Top of the ladder.
Great.
So on top of the ladder?
Yeah,
the
top of the ladder.
So let's take you down a little bit more. There we go.
4 feet. 3 feet. 2 feet. 1 foot. Touchdown.
It was dicey for a few minutes.
All right, slide.
Batman said he saw a life flash before his eyes and it was boring.
We gotta go head for the disco ball.
We did?
Yes.
Can we order those?
I'm ordering them.
Okay. Casey's broken.
What now?
Casey's broken.
So
I
can't even.
He's in the
last year. There we go. Oh my god, the book is not so monkey.
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 It's a silver. I'm about to lose
now.
Oh.
I was the last one. Alright, Casey's on the bottom.
Did you break, Tyler?
Focus, you fuck.
Actually, the second one I have this time.
4 feet. 3 feet.
Blue feet.
3 feet. 1 foot.
Old feet.
Touchdown.
Yeah.
No, he's already made too many noise puns.
Dumb question.
So
they took the ladder up the staircase and then dropped it over. Can't we just take it out?
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
Just checking. Pull it towards you. Oh god, that'll be stuck in my head for the rest of the day now, thanks. The Muppets. One. Yep, that one.
So it doesn't look like it's got robot mange, and then it's okay.
It's got the robot 7-year itch.
I got some mange happening there. Good job, kid.
I climbed it, actually.
We're going to have to get the,
the
cabinet in there.
The cabinet's only going up top because that's where all the sound system stuff is.
That's totally cool.
That's how he has it set up.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, all the wires.
So the projectionist operates sound and everything.
That's
from
totally
the
cool.
Projector.
We're going to put the speakers off in the corners.
Of course.
Stack like they were in here.
And we put the little ones in the other corner. You got sound.
And then we need to get three more speakers for center and two sides, and then we have Dolby.
We might be able to pull up enough stuff out of robotics.
Maybe.
We got some smaller cabinets down there.
We need a processor, though. We're going to do that.
That can't be hard. We've got one in stock.
We might get one Tuesday.
We might.
Fucking Jerry, we're lowering the subwoofer. We dropping the bass now?
Oh, God.
They only got worse from there.
And then we lowered the speaker, and he goes, oh, I figured we'd have more trouble with that.
Why am I not allowed to push anything else?
Did you make the robot today?
Robot not on path. Press auto for automatic repositioning, which sounds really scary.
Don't do that.
Or switch to manual mode, by which it probably
hang on,
means
hang
T1
on.
Or T2.
Is this your program?
This is starting up.
Oh.
I have not touched anything except turn on the switch yet.
We can't auto reposition the robot. That ends in pain.
Yeah, that's what I'm figuring.
Those are the little
programs. It might be. I'm not sure what mode it's on, T1, T2, whatever. Maybe I can joggle the switch. Letting you ignore it? That's really nice, though.
The robot's in external right now.
Well, I don't know if these robots need
the robot's in external because you put the plug in.
It's a man.
Well, we're at 1%.
I love you, Katie. You're like my favorite person.
I know
you are
right now.
This is staying in the cage forever and ever.
Oh, yeah, the metric tape measure.
Oh, yeah, the metric tape measure.
That doesn't need batteries.
That one's supposed to live in the Jeff toolbox, but somehow keeps ending
well,
back.
Well, it's going to now. Oh,
is it labeled?
It's
metric.
It says metricated on it.
But it doesn't say stay in robot cage, does it?
No, because the Sharpie keeps coming off.
Be it noted, stay in robot cage or robot will be trained to kill you. Does that say stay in cage enough?
I just put a brick on it.
Right under the caution sign here.
We put the RFID readers outside the cage and then stick this.
Beep, 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 beep.
That's what we'll start doing.
Fair,
just start putting like
the
store alarm systems on the side of each room. They're programmed to each. They can only leave.
It's not
so if someone tries to leave the MDA.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
I can get all the plastic tiles for less than $350.
The only way to really tell is to twist and see if it moves to the left or the right, which would switch positions.
How many is it going to take?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Try the right.
It did follow that cord. It did go back to the
other.
Just a smaller one.
Hopefully make it happy.
Yep, I'm in T1.
Alright. Just wait till we're done with the discussion.
Katie.
Yes?
These were supposed to be 3/16. Somehow they are not fitting the way that the other 3/16 did. Could you take those back and fine tune that are 3/16 proper?
Yes.
Thank you.
And if those don't work when you find them, then
I got active commands inhibited.
That doesn't surprise me.
I got some green. Just don't let me do anything.
What do they ever say?
Monitor should be working. Fair enough. Might need power.
That's power.
I got an E-stop. It wants mastering.
That doesn't surprise me.
Alright, I'm gonna master it.
No, sorry, coming through.
It's alright. It's all good.
Cable.
the hell do I switch user mode? I'm not...
User mode?
Yeah. How do you switch user mode?
How do you get the monitor working?
Oh, come on.
I'll yell at the monitor.
They're not running anything right now, that's why I had you. Hurry.
Can't find the exit.
Someone got rear.
Huh? I don't know. He went upstairs with Tyler. I don't know where he went. There he is.
It's under commands. It's not there. Motion? No. It's weird. Utility? No.
Position.
Motion setup?
Go back to monitor. Or nope. Hold on.
This is weird.
Let's see, off options. I think it might be under miscellaneous, which has all kinds of magic. Monitoring work envelope. Nope, that's my work envelope. Oh!
What?
Duh.
Is it because we were in a program?
Yes.
We were in a program.
Here you go.
God, we're dumb. Okay, master. Good. Close. You're happy. There's no program.
Okay.
And we're back. What program do I want? Yoga.
Destroy all humans.
No, that's like the third or fourth program.
I select, right? Not edit.
Press enter. And then once it is open, if you want to run it, you have to have it open before you switch to full auto mode. Because otherwise it opens its default start program and doesn't let you close it, so you can't change programs in auto right now.
Okay. Editor, wait.
They're fine.
Okay.
Yeah, this is only gonna...
Okay.
Can we get wires? Those wires we run over there?
Yeah, that's especially the expensive wires.
We're a robot.
During the robot.
Alright.
Emergency stop? No.
Yeah, there is no emergency stop. It just says there is.
Say.
did you guys take the cables?
Since there is.
The speaker cables?
All right. It's not
going to
let us go until it is convinced that there isn't a way to go. Two emergency stops, except for the electrical one. Like the sign in the way that plug-in wired. You just put the plug-in after wiring goes down. Well, just two bridges.
You two can go back to rocking.
Dominic said 1718 and 1920. And what my notebook.
Just set them there.
And yep. I took down there and used to. Where'd my notebook go? We'll make sure
Bill
I
be back.
Right.
Do it again. Do it at like 5% speed. Oh, there's lots of schmoo in there. We got rust and schmoo.
That's 1%.
Okay. We get right up in there.
Reaching the end of its limit.
Yeah, take it up.
Just needs to go the other way.
Take speed up. Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Brad Wilmot.